Now to our other big story. For the first time, we are hearing the man who confessed to planting a pipe bomb on a natural gas pipeline. Take a look. This is Daniel Herriman. That's his latest mug photo. The FBI says he admitted to putting the bomb on a line near Okemah on Wednesday. You can see the view from Sky 5 right there on your screen. The bomb squad robot trying to disarm that device. Eyewitness News 5's Michael Seiden is live with the late breaking update.
Tonight, we've obtained the 911 call made by Daniel Herriman. Now, during the 2.5 minute call, Herriman seems shaken. He also admits to placing that bomb on a gas pipe.
For the first time,
I'm calling, turn myself in.
We are hearing the chilling 911 call made by Daniel Herriman. FBI agents say the 40-year-old built a pipe bomb and strapped it to an 80-inch natural gas line.
Why would they be looking for you?
I set the bomb underneath the pipeline.
Investigators say Herriman called 911 after two gas line workers discovered the weapon. OHP's bomb squad deactivated the explosive device, preventing a horrific outcome.
Thank goodness he is not the greatest bomb maker.
Now authorities are trying to figure out Harriman's motives. From his Facebook page, he appears to be an avid fisherman, but he may have been sick. During the 911 call, Herriman admits he suffers from a mental illness.
I'm schizoaffective.
Mm-hmm.
I hear voices, and I can't control them no more. I need help.
When authorities arrived at Harriman's home, they say they found all the materials he used to make the bomb. And now he's in federal custody.
It was not a hoax by any means.
A real-life situation that could have ended in tragedy.
And I received a call this evening from a woman claiming to be Daniel's ex-girlfriend. She told me she talked to him on the day that he turned himself into authorities, and he told her by phone that he had done something that she thought would be horrible. Reporting in the newsroom, Michael Seiden, Eyewitness News 5.
Michael, thank you. Herriman is scheduled to appear in front of a judge on Monday.